Okay. Now we are going into the actual process of consolidation and conversational strategy. Now, when we do the consolidation and conversational strategy, yeah, we know that tadi strategies can be group into apa yang kita panggil clusters atau subcluster. Ini bukan cluster penyakit, clusters lah, clusters COVID-19 or whatnot. This is about strategy cluster. And each of these cluster tadi tu, right? Sometimes they redundant antara satu sama lain. You may end up having katakan about maybe 10 strategi yang sama. 10 strategi yang sama. Contoh dia tengok dekat slides number 10. 10. Dia kata example strategies, increase sales through increasing control of downstreaming activities. B, grow by diversification concentrically. D, growth by controlling resources. D, look for a partner to diversify within the same sector. Jadi kalau kita tengok all these four strategy listed, seem that is compatible, compatible. Kalau tengok grow by diversification and look for partners, sebenarnya ada satu benda yang sama, the same thing, kan? Maksudnya grow by diversification or and look for partner, maksudnya sesuatu yang related with other. Jadi kalau dia related, apa yang kita buat adalah kita group it together, group it together. Whereas increase sales dengan growth by controlling resources, that one something yang we can group it together juga. Increase sales by what? By controlling the resources. Yeah. So that is one strategy yang sama sebenarnya, right? So those are the thing that you actually condense ni maksudnya masukkan. And then you consolidate. So bila kita consolidate ataupun condense, you will see nanti later on dalam you punya apa yang kita panggil dalam you punya kajian you tentang apa tu, sekarang ni you tengah buat apa tu, Nokia dan sebagainya. I will give you another later on. Nanti ada satu case lagi adalah you, dengan tengok satu case study tu, bila you buat dia punya pester sebagainya, nampak, you akan nampak satu strategi atau dua tiga strategi yang sama. They are moving toward the same direction. Jadi kita tak boleh tulis benda yang sama 3-4 kali. Condense kan dia lagi, condense supaya dia jadi satu something that is apa kita pakai, consolidated. So dalam slides, you tengok slide nombor 13, 14, 15 tu, you can see how things are being done in term of developing strategy. Okay? Kemudian daripada development strategy itu, kita masuk di dalam group. Group apa? Kita dah group kan, group contohnya katakan yang cakap tadi, ya, kalau ikut kita ikut warna scorecard, dia ada growth in term of revenue growth dia, dia ada in term of customer satisfaction dia, dia ada in term of process improvement dia, dia ada betul IT and learning cluster dia, ya. Jadi untuk memudahkan kita semua macam mana kita nak develop the strategy ni, I nak you tengok video on balance scorecard. Yeah, balance scorecard supaya you faham. Balance scorecard ni satu tools untuk memudahkan kita untuk execute our strategy. Yeah, it's a very good tools, a very ancient tool, tetapi very useful untuk you faham why we need to use this scorecard and how this scorecard will help you to develop the ataupun how you execute the strategy. Okay then, we look into the video of the balance.